السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. All praise is due to Allah, we praise Him and we seek His assistance. We seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evils of our own selves and from the bad outcomes of our deeds. Whomever Allah guides, none can lead astray. And whomever Allah leads astray, none can guide. And I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship in truth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and messenger. Allahumma la ilma illa ma 'allamtana. Allahumma zidna 'ilma. Allahumma ij'al ma nata'allamahu hujjatan lana la 'alayna ya dhal jalali wal ikram. Brothers and sisters, today insha'Allah ta'ala we will start a new series of the explanation of Ayat al-Kursi, the greatest ayah in the Quran. And we will insha'Allah ta'ala mention the proof for that. What we would start with is the mentioning of why we are studying this ayah. First of all, because it is the most of virtuous of knowledge. The most virtuous of knowledge and the greatest of knowledge for the servant to gain is the knowledge of Tawheed. And the greatest ayah in the Quran that gathered most of the ayat of Tawheed is Ayat al-Kursi. And what we would start with, insha'Allah ta'ala, is the hadith of Ubay ibn Ka'b, radiyallahu anhu. He said, قال لي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أبا المنذر أي آية معك من كتاب الله أعظم؟ أي آية معك من كتاب الله أعظم؟ قال قلت الله ورسوله أعلم. قال يا أبا المنذر أي آية معك من كتاب الله أعظم؟ قال قلت آية الكرسي، الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. This companion, this great companion, he says that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he asked him, what is the greatest verse in the Quran with your knowledge? What is the greatest ayah in the Quran? And his companion, he said, Allah and his messenger know best. Then the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he repeated the question and he said, which ayah in the Quran is the greatest? So Ubay Aba al-Munzir, he replied, Ayat al-Kursi, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum. قال فضرب النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام بيده على صدري وقال والله ليهنك العلم يا أبا المنذر. He said that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم striked me with his hand on my chest and he said والله, swearing by Allah عز وجل, والله ليهنك العلم يا أبا المنذر. He said والله, and he congratulates him about this knowledge that Allah Azza wa Jal has bestowed upon him. Meaning that this companion answered a correct answer, first of all. So he striked him on his chest and he swore by Allah and congratulating him on this answer that this great companion answers with. Now let's contemplate on this hadith. This hadith itself has many, many lessons for us to gather, and many lessons that proves to us unto why this ayah is one of the greatest ayat in the Quran, if not the greatest ayah that Allah Azza wa Jal revealed in the Quran. Now when we speak about the greatness of this ayah in the Quran, we don't mean that there's other ayat يعني, that are not of يعني, that do not have greatness or virtues in them, no. But the greatness of this ayah is due to the statement the statements that it includes in it. Because the Quran, the one that spoke the Quran is Allah Azza wa Jal. But the ayat that are mentioned in Ayat al-Kursi mention the greatest of virtues of knowledge, which is the knowledge of Tawheed. So the knowledge of Tawheed is not the knowledge of Fiqh or the knowledge of the stories of the Prophets. The knowledge of Tawheed is the most of virtuous of knowledge. And this is why this ayah is the greatest ayah that Allah Azza wa Jal revealed in the Quran. Now let's contemplate on some of the things that we can gather from this hadith. First of all, that this companion, he chose this ayah from between 6,000 ayat or over 6,000 ayat in the Quran. He answers the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with Ayat al-Kursi, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. Now this companion, he has memorized the whole Quran at the time of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He memorized the whole Quran. So he has the whole Quran in his chest. And when the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks him at the start, what is the greatest verse? First, he answers with Allah wa rasuluhu a'lam. Allah and his messenger know best. And when the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam repeated the question, he now knew that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving him a chance to strive to answer. So straight away he answers with this correct answer. Now what has led this companion to answer with this correct answer in the same moment? Because the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not give him time يعني, to go and think about it يعني, for a day or two or a week. But rather he answered in the same moment. So what led this companion to answer with this correct answer is his great understanding of Tawheed. His great understanding of Tawheed. And by the tawfiq of Allah Azza wa Jal, and this knowledge that Allah Azza wa Jal has bestowed upon him. This is what led him to answering this with this great answer. Because out of over 6,000 ayat, he picks in his mind the ayat of Tawheed. Because it is the most virtuous of knowledge. So he thinks about the ayat of Tawheed, and he knew straight away that the most virtuous and greatest ayah out of the ayat of Tawheed is Ayat al-Kursi. The ulama, they say that this ayah, Ayat al-Kursi, it has gathered يعني, proofs about Tawheed no other ayah in the Quran has gathered. Most of the stuff that are in Ayat al-Kursi are mentioned in the Quran in various ayat. But no other ayah has gathered this many proofs about Tawheed onto why we should worship Allah Azza wa Jal, onto why Allah Azza wa Jal is the one deserving to be worshipped alone without associating any partners with him. Ayat al-Kursi has gathered most of these evidences. And this is why it is the greatest ayah. So we know that the virtue of Tawheed is the knowledge of Tawheed is the most virtuous to the Sahaba, to the companions. And this is why he answers with this quick question, with this quick answer. What is similar to this that proves to us that Tawheed is the most of important knowledge to the companions is a story that was narrated by Aisha radiallahu anha. Aisha radiallahu anha, she narrated that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sent a man, one of his companions, with a group, with a troop out on a mission. And then this companion, with every salah, he would end his salah with Qul huwallahu ahad. He would recite Qul huwallahu ahad in every salah. So this troubled them. So they came back to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, telling him with the action of this companion. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ask him, why is he doing so? Why was he reciting قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ in every salah? So they went back and they asked him. And he, رضي الله عنه, he answers, he says, لِأَنَّ فِيهَا صِفَةُ الرَّحْمَانِ وَأَنَا أُحِبُّ الرَّحْمَانِ. He said, because it has the attributes of Ar-Rahman, and I love Ar-Rahman, I love Allah Azza wa Jal. And due to this, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَخْبِرُوهُ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّهُ وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ أَنَّ حُبَّكَ إِيَّاهَ أَدْخَلَكَ الْجَنَّةِ. They said, inform him, tell him that your love to the attributes of Allah Azza wa Jal and your love to reciting this surah has caused you to enter into Jannah. And in another narration, tell him and inform him that Allah Azza wa Jal loves him. And this is why the ulama, they say that reciting the ayat that have tawheed in it is more virtuous than reciting other ayat. Shaykh, Allah, yani from memory, I think it was Shaykh Ibn Taymiyyah where he said that قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ is not the same as تَبَّتْ يَدَ أَبِي لَهَبٍ وَتَبْ, because of the statements that it has in it, which is the greatest of statements, which is the ayat of Tawheed. The ayat that show the oneness of Allah Azza wa Jal. Ayat that prove to us unto why Allah Azza wa Jal is the one worthy of worship. Why is he worthy of worship and not associated any partners with him? So this ayah is one of the greatest ayat. Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum, la ta'khuduhu sinatu wa la nawm, lahu ma fi al-samawati wa ma fi al-ard, man dha al-lazhi yashfa'u indahu illa bi-idhnih, ya'lamu ma bayna aydihim wa ma khalfahum, ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم. Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, Allah, none has the right to be worshipped but He, the ever living, Al-Hay, Al-Qayyum, the one who sustains and protects all that exists. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم, neither slumber nor sleep overtakes him. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض, to him belongs what is in the heavens and what is on earth. Who is he that can intercede with him without, except with his permission? He knows what happens to them, meaning his creation. يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم. He knows what happens to them in this world and what happens to them in the hereafter. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءٍ. And they will never compass anything of his knowledge except that which he wills. وَسِعَ كُرْسِيُّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. His kursi extends over the heavens and the earth. And he feels no fatigue in guarding and preserving them. وَهُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ. And he is the most high and the most great. This ayah, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he urged and encouraged us to recite it every day. Every day in our life. And it came in many ahadith, proves to this, that it is recited 8 times a day. 8 times a day. The first is reciting it after every obligatory prayer. After every obligatory prayer. Came in the hadith, الذي رواه النسائي في حديث أبي أمامة الباهلي رضي الله عنه. أبي أمام الباهلي he narrated. He said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قرأ آية الكرسي في دبر كل صلاة مكتوبة لم يمنعه من دخول الجنة إلا أن يموت. He said that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever recites the verse of Al-Kursi after every obligatory prayer will have nothing preventing him from entering paradise except his death. Except his death. Nothing will prevent him from entering paradise except his death. This is reciting it after every obligatory prayer. قال ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى, he said, بلغني عن شيخنا أبي العباس ابن تيمية قدس الله روحه أنه قال ما تركتها عقيب كل صلاة. That ابن تيمية, he said that he was informed that عفوا ابن القيم said that he was informed that ابن تيمية said that he after listening or after hearing this hadith of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said ما تركتها عقيب كل صلاة, that I did not leave off reciting Ayat al-Kursi after every obligatory prayer. This is 5 times a day after every prayer. And what is narrated in Sahih al-Bukhari min hadith Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu, and this is a beautiful hadith. This hadith is a beautiful hadith, again, a proof unto reciting Ayat al-Kursi before going to bed. So this is the 6th time before going to bed. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he narrated, he said, وَكَّلَنِي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ بِحِفْظِ زَكَاةِ رَمَضَانِ. He said that the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم put me in charge onto the charity of Zakat al-Fitr in Ramadan. He was in charge of guarding Zakat al-Fitr. فأتاني آت فجعل يحث من الطعام. He said, then a man came and he was taking some of Zakat al-Fitr to himself. وقلت فأخذته وقلت والله لأرفعنك إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So he captured him and he said, Wallah, I'm going to take you to the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال إني محتاج وعلي عيال ولي حاجة شديدة. He complained to him that he is in need and he has a big family. فخليت عنه. So he said, Abu Huraira, he said, so I let him go. And in the morning, فأصبحت فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أبا هريرة ما فعل أسيرك البارحة. When I woke up, the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said to me, O Abu Huraira, what did your captive do last night? فقلت خليت سبيله, that I let him go. He came, he was taking some of the food and he complained to me. يعني he is in need and he has a big family, so I let him go. فقال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام قال أما إنه قد كذبك وسيعود. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said to him, ألا إنه قد كذبك وسوف يعود. He said he had lied to you and he would come back. So the next night, فعرفت أنه سيعود. أبو هريرة, he said, so I knew he would come back. فعرفت أنه سيعود لقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه سيعود, because the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم informed him that he would come back. فرصدته, then he waited for him the next night. فجعل يحث من الطعام, then he came the next night and he was taking some of the food. فأخذته فقلت لأرفعنك إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then he captured him and he said, والله I will take you to the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال دعني فإني محتاج وعلي عيال. He said, let me go because I am in need and I have a family. قال لا أعود فرحمته فخليت سبيله. He said, and I would not come back. So Abu Huraira, he let him go. And then the next morning, the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, يا أبا هريرة ما فعل أسيرك؟ قلت يا رسول الله شكى حاجة شديدة وعيالا فرحمته فخليت سبيله. He said, he came and he took some of the food and I captured him. And then he complained to me about his needs and he has a big family. So I let him go. فقال أما إنه قد كذبك وسيعود. He said he lied to you, Abu Huraira, and he would come back. فرصدته ثالثا. He said, and on the third occasion, I waited for him because the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم informed him that he would come back. فجعل يحث من الطعام. Then he started taking from the food again. فأخذته فقلت لأرفعنك إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, I captured him and I said to him that I would take you to the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. وهذا آخر ثلاث مرات تزعم أنك لا تعود ثم تعود. He said, this is the third time that you say to me that you would not come back and you came back. قال دعني أعلمك كلمات. He said, leave me and I will teach you some words. ينفعك الله بها, that Allah عز وجل would benefit you with. قلت وما هن؟ أبو هريرة said to him, what are these words? قال إذا أويت إلى فراشك, that if you go to bed, فقرأ آية الكرسي. Then recite آية الكرسي. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. Allah, none has the right to be worshipped but He. حتى تختم الآية, until you finish the آية. فإنك لن يزال عليك من الله حافظ. ولا يقربك شيطان حتى تصبح. Then you would have someone that protects you overnight. And no shaitan will come near you for the whole night until the morning. فخليت سبيله. Then I let him go. فأصبحت. And then he woke up. فقال لي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما فعل أسيرك البارحة. The messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he asked him again, what did your captive do last night? قلت يا رسول الله زعم أنه يعلمني كلمات ينفعني الله بها. He said that he taught me some words claiming that Allah Azza wa Jal would benefit me with these words. فخليت سبيله, so I let him go. قال وما هي؟ قال, he said, what are these words that he said? قلت, قال لي إذا أويت إلى فراشك فقرأ آية الكرسي من أولها حتى تختم الآية الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. He said that if you go to bed, recite the words of Ayat al-Kursi, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. Qala li lan yazalu alayka min Allah hafiz, that there would be a protector from Allah azza wa jal upon you overnight. Wa la yaqrabuka shaytanun hatta tusbih, and no shaytan will come near you until the morning. Wa kanu ahrasa shay'in 'ala al-khayr, fa qala an-nabiy alayhi as-salatu was-salam ama innahu sadaqaka wa huwa kadhub. The messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, he was truthful to you, but he is a liar. He was truthful to you, but he is a liar. تعلم من تخاطب منذ ثلاث ليال يا أبا هريرة. He said, do you know who you have been speaking to the past three nights, O Abu Huraira? قال لا. He said, no, I don't. قال ذاك الشيطان. He said, that was the shaytan. Subhanallah. This is the virtue of this ayah. And Abu Huraira, he did not take the words from the shaitan and run away with them before asking the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because a lot of people, they think that you can take knowledge from anyone, yani knowing that knowledge is true, without asking. And they use this hadith as evidence. But we see here that Abu Huraira, he did not take these words and did not implement these words until he asked the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then after the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam confirming, then comes the action. Another hadith, now this is six we mentioned. Five times after salat and one before bed. Now there are two more times, because we mentioned there are eight times this ayah is recited during the day and the night, every day and night, and the other two times is in the morning and in the evening remembrances. And the evidence to this is hadith Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu. He said, أنه كان له جرن من تمر. He had يعني a pot made out of stone that they used to put tamar in there. They used to put dates in there to preserve the tamar. فكان ينقص. Then he realized that this pot was getting empty every time. Someone was taking from the tamar. فحرسه ذات ليلة. So he waited. يعني waited nearby to see who has been coming and taken from these. فإذا هو بدابة شبه الغلام المحتلم. Then يعني this creature came to take from this tamar. The creature came. فسلم عليه فرد عليه السلام. He said السلام عليكم, and then he replied to him السلام. فقال ما أنت جني أم إنسي. Ubay ibn Ka'b asked him, are you a jinni or are you an insi? Are you from the jinn or are you from mankind? Qala jinni. He said, from jinn kind. Qala fanawiluni yaduka. He said, give me your hand. Fanawalahu yaduhu. Then he gave him his hand. Fa'idha yaduhu yadu kalbin. Then his hand is the hand of a dog. وشعره شعر كلب, and his hair is the hair of a dog. قال هذا خلق الجن. He said that is the creation of jinn. قال قد علمت الجن قد قال قد علمت الجن أن ما فيهم رجلا أشد مني. He said that the jinn know that there is no other man, meaning who, meaning Ubay ibn Ka'b, that is more harsh يعني unto them than me. قال فما جاء بك, what brings you here. قال بلغني أنك تحب الصدقة. He said, I was informed that you like to give صدقة. فجئنا نصيب من طعامك. We came to take some of your food. قال فما ينجين منكم. This is a question that Ubay asked his jinni. He said, what saves us or what protects us from you, jinn kind. قال هذه الآية التي في سورة البقرة. He said, this ayah that is in سورة البقرة. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. من قالها حين يمسي أجير منا حتى يصبح. He said, this ayah in the Quran, in سورة البقرة, الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. Whoever says it in the morning, أجير منا حتى عفواً. Whoever says it in the evening is protected from us until the morning. ومن قالها حين يصبح أجير منا حتى يمسي. And whoever says it in the morning is protected from us until the evening. فلما أصبح, then when the morning came, أتى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Again, he came to the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. فذكر ذلك. Then he informed the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم of what happened. فقال صدقك الخبيث. صدق الخبيث. He said, this خبيث صدقك. الخبيث here meaning malignant. يعني a malicious person. He said صدقك. Means he was truthful. Again, this companion did not implement these words until what? Until he went back to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he asked him, and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam affirmed it. So these are eight times that this ayah, this great ayah, is recited every day and every night in these eight places. Now one might ask the question, why do we recite this ayah? Why do we recite this ayah every day, in the morning, in the evening, after every salah? The ulama, they say, it is nothing but istithkar lil-tawheed. That someone, yani that person, remembers tawheed, refreshes his tawheed 8 times a day. But this recitation of this ayah does not come by just reciting it. That these ahadith are not mentioned so that you can just recite this ayah, but rather to really understand the meaning of this ayah, to really understand the proofs that Allah Azza wa Jal has gathered in this ayah. The proofs of Tawheed, the proofs onto why Allah Azza wa Jal is deserving to be worshipped. And there are many proofs in this ayah. Insha'Allah ta'ala, in the coming classes we will mention them. Allah Azza wa Jal, after mentioning that He is the only one worthy of worship, then He mentions 12 evidences onto why. 12 evidences. Now these are not only 12 things, but 12 evidences, insha'Allah ta'ala, we will mention in the next coming classes, if Allah Azza wa Jal gives us life. These evidences include, like we said, the greatness of Allah Azza wa Jal. They include the kursi, the mention of the kursi of Allah Azza wa Jal. The kursi of Allah Azza wa Jal. They include conditions of intercession. They include that Allah Azza wa Jal is above all. Evidences, insha'Allah ta'ala, we'll mention in the classes coming. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.